Good morning, students. Hope so everyone is fit and fine. So students, we will start a new chapter today. That is your chapter number 4, and the name of the chapter is your table, links and frames in HTML5. So students, in this chapter you will get how we can insert tables, links, frame in HTML5. So everyone take out to your page number 71. Page number 71, and look in your first paragraph. In the previous chapter, you learned how to create list and insert graphics in an HTML document. Other important elements that you can add to your HTML document are table, hyperlinks and frames. So in our previous chapter, that is your chapter number 3, in chapter number 3 you have got 3 different types of list, is not it? That is your ordered list, unordered list and description list. Now in this chapter you will get about table, links and frames. Then students, you come to your second paragraph. You know that a website consists of many web pages. These web pages are linked to each other using hyperlinks. Yes, here what is a hyperlink? Hyperlink, it simply means your linking. How we can link from one web page to another? That is your linking. Okay, that is your hyperlink. A hyperlink is usually an underlined word, phrase, image or icon that leads the readers to a new web address when the user clicks on it. So here students, what is a hyperlink? It is your underlined word. It may be a word, it may be a phrase, means a paragraph or a phrase, or image or an icon, okay, that helps the reader to connect from one web page to another. Clear? Hyperlink can be used to jump from one location to another within the same page, from one web page to another or to another website. Just now I have said you, okay, what I have said you, that hyperlink, you can say it is simply your linking. It means your linking from one web page to another, okay, one web page to another, and showing the user that all it will be displayed in one individual page, okay. It can be created in all in one individual page. Then students, you come in the next topic, that is your creating tables. How we are going to create tables in your HTML5? So see here, creating tables. A table arranges data in rows and columns. Now when we are talking about tables, firstly, what do you mean by table? A table is a combination of your rows and columns. Is not it? You have got before. What is a table? Table is your combination of your rows and column. And that particular rectangular blocks are what? That particular rectangular box or blocks are your cells. Okay. Tables in web pages makes the data easier to read and interpret. Professional quality website always use tables where the cells contain text, graphics and links. Page number 72, okay. Tables are powerful tool for laying out the contents of web page. Using tables, the designer can place a text and graphics anywhere on the page. Now here students, in tables, okay, tables are very helpful for the user, because tables, you can say that it helps the user to get the information very easily and smoothly, because in tables the data are entered very nicely. In each rows and columns, the contents of the data are given very systematic, in a very systematic manner. Clear? Then students, you will find here basic table tags. So here you will find some of the table tags. So everyone look at table 4.1. In 4.1 you will get here 5 table tags. Okay. The first one, you have a look. On table, off table. Okay. First one is your on table tag and your off table tag. And what is the main function? This is the main tag used to define a table in HTML. Yes, this on table and off table, what is the main function? It is useful for making the table in HTML document. It is useful to define a table in your HTML document. Then students, you see to the next one. That one is your on tr and off tr, tr. Here tr stands for your table row tag. Okay, t table r row. So tr stands for your table row tag. And what is the function? The table row tag defines a horizontal row. Okay, it will define the horizontal row of a cell. Clear? Third one is your TD, on TD, off TD. Okay, that is your table data tag, table data tag. And what is the function? The table data specifies an individual block or cell in a table row. So what is the main function of TD? Data. When I am talking about data, it means what? It will keep the informations. Okay. Here TD, you can say it helps the user to keep the information. Okay. It helps the user to keep the information in a particular block, in a particular individual block. Okay. It will come in a individual block, not in a multiple. Okay. It will come in your individual block. Individual means what? One. Then the fourth one is your TH, on TH, off TH. That is, TH stands for your table header cell. Okay, table header cell. And what is the function? The table header indicates that the cell is a header for a column or row. So here, the main function by the name itself, header. Header, it means what? Head. Head is always at the top. Okay, head is always at the top, up. So the main function of your TH, okay, table header cell, is it is used to indicate the cell where? At the top, at the head of a column or a row. Then the next one, the last one, that is your fifth one, is your on caption, off caption. Okay, table caption or heading tag. You can call this one as your table caption or heading tag. And what is the function? Table caption heading defines a caption for the data of the table. So here what happened? In this caption, okay, in this on caption and off caption, it will help to give the heading of the table. Okay, it will give you, it will help you to give the heading or the caption of the table. So, clear students this much? So, students, hyperlink, you have understood what I have explained, hyperlink. Again, I am warming it up to you. What is a hyperlink? A hyperlink is usually an underlined word, phrase, image or icon that leads the reader to a new web address when the user clicks on it. Okay, means we can move from one web page to another very easily. We can link from one page to another very easily. Clear? Then here, next one, you will get how we can create a tables, okay? And you will get here basic table tags. How many table tags you have got here? You have got here 5 table tags. What are they? First one, on table, off table. Second one, on tr, off tr. Third one, on td, off td. Fourth one, on TH, off TH. Fifth one, on caption, off caption. Clear? Here, table, it will remain the same table tag. TR, it stands for your table row tag. TD stands for your table data tag. TH stands for your table header cell. And the caption that will stand for your table caption or heading tag. Clear students? No doubt regarding this? So students, whatever I have explained you today, you go through your books very nicely. In my next class, students, I will explain you about table properties. Okay, I will explain you about table properties. So now students, I am winding up my class here. Thank you to all and have a nice day ahead.